light and peace in Jesus Christ our Lord. Thanks be to God. Almighty God, we give you thanks for surrounding us as daylight fades with the brightness of your Vesper light, and we implore you of your great mercy that as you enfold us with the radiance of this light, so you would shine into our hearts the brightness of your Holy Spirit, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
And will be forever. How great are his signs, how mighty his wonders. His kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and his sovereignty is from generation to generation. I, Nebuchadnezzar, was living at ease in my home and prospering in my palace. I saw a dream that frightened me. My fantasies in bed and the visions of my head terrified me. So I made a decree that all wise men of Babylon should be brought before me in order that they might tell me the interpretation of the dream. Then the magicians, the enchanters, the Chaldeans, and the diviners came in, and I told them the dream. But they could not tell me its interpretation. At last, Daniel came in before me, he who was named Belteshazzar, after the name of my God, and who is endowed with the spirit of the holy gods. And I told him the dream. Oh, Belteshazzar, chief of the magicians, I know that you are endowed with the spirit of the holy gods, and that no mystery is too difficult for you. Hear the dream that I saw. Tell me its interpretation. Upon my bed, this is what I saw. There was a tree at the center of the earth, and its height was great. The tree grew great and strong. Its top reached to heaven, and it was visible to the ends of the whole earth. Its foliage was beautiful, its fruit abundant, and it provided food for all. The animals of the field found shade under it. The birds of the air nested in its branches, and from it all living beings were fed. I continued looking in the visions of my head as I lay in bed, and there was a holy watcher coming down from heaven. He cried aloud and said, "Cut down the tree and chop off its branches. Strip off its foliage and scatter its fruit. Let the animals flee from beneath it, and the birds from its branches. But leave its stump and roots in the ground, with a band of iron and bronze in the tender grass of the field. Let him be bathed with the dew of heaven, and let his lot be with the animals of the field and the grass of the earth. Let his mind be changed from that of a human. Let the mind of an animal be given to him, and let seven times pass over him." The sentence is rendered by decree of the watchers. The decision is given by the order of the holy ones, in order that all who live may know that the Most High is sovereign over the kingdom of mortals. He gives it to whom he will and sets over it the lowliest of human beings. This is a dream that I, King Nebuchadnezzar, saw. Now you, Belteshazzar, declare the interpretation. Since all the wise men of my kingdom are unable to tell me the interpretation, you are able, however, for you are endowed with the spirit of the holy gods. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
But as for you, men of God, shun all this. Pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, endurance, gentleness. Fight the good fight of the faith. Take hold of the eternal life to which you are called and for which you made the good confession in the presence of many witnesses. In the presence of God, who gives life to all things, and of Christ Jesus, who, in his testimony before Pontius Pilate, made the good confession. I charge you to keep the commandment without spot or blame until the manifestation of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he will bring about at the right time. He who is the blessed and only sovereign, the King of kings and the Lord of lords. It is he alone who has immortality and dwells in unapproachable light, whom no one has ever seen or can see. To him be honor and eternal dominion. Amen. As for those who in the present age are rich, commend them not to be haughty or to set their hopes on the uncertainty of riches, but rather on God, who richly provides us with everything for our enjoyment. They are to do good, to be rich in good works, generous and ready to share, thus storing up for themselves a treasure of a good foundation for the future, so that they may take hold of the life that really is life. Timothy, guard what has been entrusted to you. Avoid the profane chatter and contradictions of what is falsely called knowledge. By professing it, some have missed the mark as regards the faith. Grace be with you. This is the word of the Lord.
Nation.
Holy and loving God, as the daylight fades away and passes into night, remind us that you are the true light of the world. May the light of your Son, Jesus Christ, bring grace and healing into those places in our lives that are sinking into darkness. May your eternal and sacred light be a source of peace and comfort to us now and all the days of our lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord of all creation, we lift up to you our world leaders and policy makers who are debating how best to mitigate and heal the ways we have devastated your sacred creation. Grant them wisdom and courage through your Holy Spirit to enact policies and strategies that will treat your creation with proper reverence, so that we might glorify your craftsmanship and enable the flourishing of all creatures. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious Father, there is not one creature upon earth who suffers outside of your knowledge and compassion. And so we pray on behalf of the veterans within our community and within our country who suffer from homelessness, poverty, trauma, injuries, and thoughts of suicide. May they be filled with your grace, love, comfort, and peace. And may your Holy Spirit guide us in wisdom and compassion to be a church, a community, and a country that takes care of these people whom you love. We are grateful for their intentions and courage to serve and help. So grant us similar intentions of care for all veterans around us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.